How's it going? It's kind of a rainy day today. We're beginning of May, just about, end of April 2024. I want to show a little bit of progress for the stages of our tiny house cottage project. I've been working on the tiny house for a little while in my spare time, taking ages to put the cladding on. We're using the old 3-inch cladding, chamfer board stuff, takes forever. Banging your thumb, hammering those things on. Got to pre-drill everything because the hardwood's harder than, it's like steel from back in the day. That's real good. The transition with the digger down the hill didn't quite go as planned. Looked all good until I got to the steep part of the hill and went to turn to go across before the dam, and because the old digger has got no guts in the slew motor, I couldn't hold it up and turn. It actually overtook the digger and pushed it around sideways and nearly flipped me upside down and crushed the side wall in, almost devastating consequences. Luckily, only minor damage and smashed window, and I'll show you that. It looks like a bit of a Steptoe and Sons, or like a cyclone's come through and thrown tin everywhere down here. Whoa. But it's gonna be a great place when we do this cottage. And I'm using the tiny house as a workshop at the moment, as I'm denailing 50,000 rusty nails out of this old wood. So that's been the last couple of days, but I am getting there. Timber rafters, joist bearers from pre-World War II wood, kind of cool. All the old hardwood studs and stuff like that. And a heap of VJ, which will be the internal lining of the walls. Looks like this. You can't buy this stuff like that anymore. That's actually a hardwood, these little ones. Use some old wood with a bolt through it. It'll be exposed. The rest will be lined with this kind of stuff, I think. Needs a little bit of a tidy up. Looks like Will's bedroom in here. I reckon the cottage is going to go over here toward the creek a bit. And the sun comes up just through either that gap or that gap. I can't remember which. We'll have to work that out. So we've got a good view down here of the water. You can see down there. Not a bad bit of a water hole here, except for the prickly bunya pines right near it. But that's just below where the cottage will be once we clean up this. Ooh, raspberries in here too. Not on at the moment. Here's the bunya nuts. It's trying to grow. You don't want to be under here when one of those suckers fall down. They're about as big as a basketball and weigh 10 times as much. Kids had a cubby house in the tree down here about 8 years ago when we first moved here. A little bit worse for wear. Had some fun there. I actually had this dug out. We'd baptized some people here. Kids would jump out of here and down into there, but she's filled in again a couple of floods later. The track we can drive across the creek in this section. Got a roadway up to the cottage again, so should be good, eh? The campsite over this side for visitors. Haven't mowed it in a bit. This creek comes from a spring up the gully in the neighbour's place, so even in the worst drought, it'll still be running, not quite as much as this. Nevertheless, keeps running as long as no one's pumping out of it too much. I dug a little dam as my first attempt at building a dam. A bit of a lap pool for Missy. That's my wife. 20 metres long. Comes with frogs and tadpoles and toads. She's not real keen on. Unfortunately, even though it's lot of clay and should have been perfect. I still managed to mess it up, and the wall doesn't have enough clay in the base of it, and it leaks, so it gets pretty wet down the bottom here. And in the real wet, it's all wet all the way through there. So I want to try and make this damn wall bigger, dig that out a bit bigger, which a bigger digger would be helpful because mine's a bit steady on the slopes. This will be a roadway to drive across to the cottage. Up, keeping out of the wet, there's another road we cut through there, which is pretty cool. Another access, if people come and stay, then we wouldn't even see them arrive if they came through the jungle track. Over there's the bore, the solar panel, and the tank way up the top there. I don't know if you can see that. So the solar pump from the bore pushes right up to the tank in the top corner of the block, and gravity runs the rest, so it's about 40 pound pressure down here by the time we get 40 meters down the hill. So that's the only pump we run, is the solar one, so that is awesome. Gonna get much better than that setup. I think I made a video of setting up that bore pump. I used to just throw that submersible pump in the creek here and pump from there, but in the dry, even that was stopping the flow of the creek, which is kind of not allowed. So, there goes the wallaby. Cooper's after it. Needs to burn off some of that pork fat I gave him this morning so he can have a run. And I was sitting up here at the house, looking out over all this open country where you need the sunlight to run the solar, right? And I said, Lord, if there could be anywhere where we put this bore, if the man who looks for the water can find it, against that fence over there, right below the tank, would be my pick. So, you know, just saying, if you want to help us out, that's exactly where he found about 800 gallons an hour, only 10 meters deep. So it cost me like $2,000 or $3,000 or something, and capped it off and threw the submersible pump, which I already had down the hole. And yeah, haven't looked back. It just wobbles away all day. Sometimes the tank's overflowing if I don't turn it off. And that'll water the little paddocks and with enough pressure. And actually, we run all the house off that water as well, except for drinking water. We got a little tank off the shed at a separate tap, but otherwise, we don't have to think about how much water we're using because it's always coming. And that changes everything if you don't have water issues. It's not salty. You could drink it. You can taste a bit of minerally. It's got manganese and some other minerals in it, which you can taste it a bit, but I'm sure you could live on it. Left the window down last night. Always fun. Wet butt before you start. Gonna be homesteading or ranching or whatever y'all like to call it, a digger is probably the first machine you'd buy. Tractor's good if you're gonna be working ground and stuff, but the amount of things you can do with a little digger, this is a 3-tonner, and it's big enough to pull trees out, get the auger to drill your post holes and fix your driveway, lift heavy things when you're building, just endless things. It doesn't take dirt quickly from one place to another with a tractor with a bucket, because it's good for that. But luckily my old man's got a new tractor just down the road I can borrow, so he borrows this one, and if I can borrow his, that works out pretty good. You can see I've had this timber sitting here for that long. These wattle trees have grown up over the top of it, but the timber's still good. I'm just gonna try and find it again, but this digger is the only machine that you'd want to be doing this with, because this stuff here is spiky as. You'd be stinging in the bath if you were pulling that out by hand, trust me. Thank you. as you can tell, 20 minutes on the digger decimates the weeds in an organic kind of way too. We don't want to be spraying chemicals around here, especially not near creeks, waterways and stuff.
Did you get that wallaby? Did ya? There's actually a dead one up there that I went and got off the road for him to have something to pick at over the next couple of days. Saves a bit of dog food, doesn't it? Otherwise he keeps the place free from ferals. The boys have cut a pretty ripper motocross track around here now. Who's this coming? Might be campers. So we've actually got a hip camp across the road. Bunya Grove it's called. Which I don't really want to advertise because the more people there, the more neighbours we have, but they're usually pretty well behaved. I might be there. They're just arriving. Coop, leave them. Oi. Come, buddy, back here. I don't need your help setting up camp. Also utilise the old cattle yards as the chicken run. That's pretty good, but the chooks get out of it, but the rooster can't. So it's kind of works because that way they can free range. Water's getting down a bit there too. So they get their own food a lot. You save a lot of food if you're free ranging them. And if the rooster can't get out, they always come back to him for protection. If he's out, they're everywhere up the house and on the veranda. This is another place the chooks like to hang out. Looks like I'll let them do their own decorating. We used to milk in here with old Clarabelle. Just nose her up to this section here and hook her old matted tail on a nail and milk her from that side. But yes, I just throw hay and chook food in here. Now we're gonna set that shed up over there. A bit better for milking. Millie's, our Jersey heifer, hasn't gone into calf yet, unless that bull did his job next door when she escaped into the neighbours, which I don't know if that's possible. She's pretty small and he was massive. Yeah, chooks are pretty happy otherwise. You can see the kind of pressure I've got here at the house, which is halfway down the hill. So that's just gravity from that tank, so cool to not have to run a pump and get that. Now my brother-in-law Luke gave me this old cattle crush. Actually would have been a beaut one in its day, a little bit rusty, but works enough for what I need it to do. Actually has squeezed sides and everything, but generally just the head belt. Oh, needs a grease. Is enough. I'm going to try and put it in the race over here one day. Another job to get to, but we don't need it that often. Only if we're putting a ring on a steer or something, or making a steer. We just come back from our first 2 week holiday with the Brentwood van. I'll do an intro demo of that. It's a pretty cool van, really happy with it. I only just got me upgraded the Hilux, got a 2015 model. With the custom tray, I'm getting canvas made up for their sides because it was a bit daggy. But in that, I don't know if you've seen these head units, it's playing up. It's just got this weird loading screen busted thing and I can't get anything to work, so I don't know if anyone can comment about that, or you just throw it away and get an Apple Play. Will's got the old Hilux and building his own little pad.
What's that?
It's a camera. That's a phone, but... Oh, good on you. Leave the crowbar in the grass for the mower. Thanks.
You can go now.
It's all coming together. Looks like your bedroom.
Crashing, hit a wall. Right now, I need a miracle. Hurry up now, I need a miracle. Stranded, reaching out. I call your name.
need you right now. So don't let me, down. I think I'm losing my mind now. It's in my head, darling, I hope that you'll be here when I need you the most. So don't.